Radio Humber News at 3:30. I'm Kathleen Peroff. It's 13 degrees in Toronto. The forecast, sunny with clouds. The Jaffer Georgia saga continues in Ottawa this afternoon with Toronto businessman Nazim Gilani poised to testify. Gilani will appear before a Commons committee to answer questions about his involvement with former MP Raheem Jaffer. Gilani says he will clarify his business relationship with Jaffer by providing contacts and emails to the committee. Jaffer said that while he did meet with Gilani several times, they did not have a business relationship. The federal conservatives face an ultimatum after a historic ruling from the Speaker of the House. Peter Milliken says conservatives must hand over all documents dealing with the abuse of Afghan detainees, giving Parliament 2 weeks to craft a compromise. Opposition parties will celebrate the decision, saying the will of Parliament has been respected. In a short 86-word response, the government says it will review its options.
We welcome the possibility of a compromise while respecting our legal obligations as acknowledged by the Speaker.
If the Conservatives refuse, they could face a snap election or be held in contempt. The pretrial hearing for Canadian Omar Khadr has been delayed until this afternoon. The delay gives lawyers time to read new military commission rules that were only made available last night. If convicted, Khadr could be jailed for life. This is the first war crimes tribunal since World War II to prosecute someone for crimes committed as a child. Khadr was just 15 when he was arrested in 2002 and is accused of killing an American medic in Afghanistan with a hand grenade. A spokesman for the U.S. Coast Guard says they will begin burning some of the thickest oil patches in a massive slick off the coast of Louisiana today. The spillage is the result of last week's huge explosion at a BP oil rig, which left 11 workers missing and presumed dead. Authorities say the largest pockets of oil will be corralled for a controlled burn. Going overseas now, officials in Thailand say a clash between government forces and protesters has killed a soldier and wounded 18 civilians. Officials say the violence occurred as troops tried to block protesters from advancing along a highway north of Bangkok. It is the 27th fatality in the recent political violence that has divided the country. A man has stabbed and wounded 18 young children in southern China. The stabbing comes the same day a man was executed for killing 8 children in a school last month. And if things weren't going bad enough for British Prime Minister Gordon Brown, they may have just gotten worse. Brown was caught on tape calling a 66-year-old woman, a longtime Labour Party supporter, bigot. Brown is currently trailing in Britain's election campaign. A South Korean woman is the first woman to climb all 14 of the world's tallest mountains, dubbed the 8,000ers because each peak is over 8,000 meters tall. The feat was accomplished last night after a 13-hour climb through high winds and without oxygen. Her claim is already being challenged by a Spanish climber who is set to finish the last of the peaks in a few weeks. And here at Humber, flags are at half-mast today. The Office of the Registrar says the flags were lowered to honor workers killed on the job as part of a national day of mourning. Radio Humber News time is 3:30. Sports is next. 96.9 Sports. Continuing to struggle on the mound, the Toronto Blue Jays lost to the Boston Red Sox last night 2-1. Although Jays starter Sean Markham held strong for 7 solid innings, the bullpen failed to continue the trend. With the bases loaded, reliever Kevin Gregg walked in the go-ahead run to give the Red Sox the win. Losing their last 4 outings, the Jays have sunk below .500 for the first time since opening night. The Red Sox have clinched their spot in the second round of the NHL playoffs. Motor City was firing on all cylinders last night as they cruised to a 6-1 win over the Phoenix Coyotes. Pavel Datsyuk scored twice in less than 2 minutes, helping to put an end to the Coyotes' fairy tale season. The Wings will have little time to celebrate as they get set to take on the Western Conference champion San Jose Sharks in the second round. Soccer fans in Toronto are getting the chance of a lifetime today. The World Cup trophy is making its only stop in Canada, giving fans a chance to view one of the sport's most coveted prizes. The trophy is on an 83-country tour to celebrate the opening of the tournament. Following a media event at Pearson Airport, the 18-karat gold statue will head downtown to the CBC building for a public viewing. The World Cup kicks off on June 11th in South Africa. That's Radio Humber Sports, the weather for Toronto and Southern Ontario after this. 96.9 Satellite Weather. It feels more like fall today in Toronto with a northerly wind blowing in. This afternoon, we went above our expected high of 12 and hit a high of 13 degrees. There will be clear skies this evening, but with a low of 5 that will give way to a beautiful sunny Thursday with a high of 18 degrees. This weekend looks like it won't be as pleasant, as spring showers will move in and we could see upwards of 20 millimeters in rain. Currently, it's 13 degrees in Toronto. Now back to the music on All-Canadian 96.9 Radio Humber.